Hi, greetings, welcome, fellow humans. Most of you might not know me, but those of you who do, I attempt to try to run a VR gaming and development channel on YouTube. However, this video is a little bit out of my norms for what I normally do. And it's sort of something that's been brought to light. And I kind of feel a little bit passionate about this. And I mean, on my way home here from the stations today, on my way home from work, I've just been running this argument over and over and over in my head, and I just need to get it out. Now, if I was to write this up, it'll probably take me a day and a night to do, and I've still got to do my my live stream broadcast for today. However, so I'm just going to video this, and I may put it up on my channel at some point later in the future. But just to get this out of my head right now. Now, I was talking to someone on Facebook about rape culture. Yes, I use the quotation fingers there, and you'll see why in a few moments. And now, how everyone is currently obsessed about this rape culture that we are in at the moment, and that we should be trying our best to get out of this rape culture. And well, I mean, there's a lot of opinions going left, right and centre, and to be perfectly honest, I think that, I know this might be odd sound coming from a guy who, well, I am never going to be the victim. Just look at me. I am never going to be the victim of rape out here, am I? I mean, if anything does happen, it'll be because I'd want it to. And if I don't want it to, I'll basically throw the person in the air if anything happens. I'm not ever going to be the person of rape culture. So I'm not going to be able to... I'm never going to ever be 100%. I haven't really got arguments behind me, but I know morality. I know what's right. I know what should be the case. I know in an ideal world, in a magical magical cloud-based city where all things are perfect, everything right, everything's all right with the world, no one gets raped, no means no. Fine, yes. That's how it should be. Common sense, that's the word I was looking for. It's common sense not to rape people. You just don't do it. You're not supposed to. You shouldn't do it. And if you do, if you are the type of person that goes out there and rape people, you are an evil person. Yes, go ahead and kill yourself. Simple. Yeah, don't. Yes, go ahead and kill yourself. Because you should not be going out there to on the sole basis of that you want to rape people. No, that's not human. In saying that, that is very much human. Our history is filled with rape and violence. I mean, going back to the age of like Genghis Khan, how many times in these stories have we hear rape and pillage when it comes to the sack of a new city? You're just because two conflicting arguments don't work out. You've got a massive army on someone's front doorstep, and when they barge through, the first thing they do is put everyone to the sword after raping them. That's human history. But it's not the rape culture we are talking about at the moment. The rape culture that we are talking about right now. I got a message on Facebook, and it was basically, teach people not to... What should you do not to be raped? Okay, how to teach people not to rape. Or actually, I think the best word is teach people how to avoid rape. That's the correct word. How to avoid rape. And it says, if you feel like you're going to rape someone, take a whistle with you. And then if you feel like you're going to rape someone, blow the whistle. Let your date know that you're going to rape them in advance. And also, bring another person so that they can stop you from raping if you feel like you feel you're going to rape. Basically, it's trying to teach people, men, to, men to not rape. Fine, Yeah, okay. You shouldn't rape people. Yeah, I can understand that. Perfect. Good. One thumbs up for you. But then it went on. It went on saying that women should not have to police themselves. Women should not have to worry about what they're wearing. Women should not have to look after their drinks. Women should not worry about going out alone in the middle of the night. Well, again, you're right. In that magical land that I told you about, where bright rainbows and unicorns and all things are right with the world and everything's perfect, that would be the correct situation. Women should not have to worry about that. But this isn't a perfect world. Look out the window and tell me how perfect it is. It's not. You got rape. We have to deal with it. We've got inhuman people out there, bastards, assholes, you name it, they're out there. You've got all manner of depraved, depressing, depraved, depressing things that all of humanity can provide. And believe me, we can provide quite a lot of depravity out there. And you're saying you don't have to be careful. Don't police your drinks. Don't worry about what you wear. Don't go out without having friends to look after you. Go out on your own. And this is what I refer to as something that I heard before on another web comic that I used to read. A web comic, I think it was either Sluggy Freelance or was it Sluggy Freelance or what, User Friendly or sorry, I can't remember who it was. They had this thing called weapons grade stupidity. I like that term. I'm taking that. I like that term. Weapons grade stupidity, because that is exactly what this is. Weapons grade stupidity in stupidity, if I can pronounce it right, basically means that that it's a stupidity on such a high level that it can get someone killed. It can cause murders. It can cause death and destruction. Weapons grade stupidity or military grade stupidity that can end someone's life. And that's what this is. This is weapons grade stupidity. Telling women don't police their drinks. Don't be go out on your own. Go because you're not the one that's at fault here. It's humanity's a fault. They should be safe. They should not want to do this. They should not be assholes out there, basically. They shouldn't be dickheads. They shouldn't be humans out there, basically. And if women actually believed that, yeah, I tell you what, I'm going to wear a belt for a skirt. A belt for a skirt and a very long necked V-neck so you can see pretty much my entire breasts, and I'm going to walk out in the middle of the night, even though it's probably freezing cold, down the darkened street. I should be fine because humanity should not be like that. Then they're going to get killed. They're going to be robbed. They're going to get robbed, murdered, and then the corpse are going to be raped and left in the ditch because there are people out like that. There is depravity out there like that. That's why I call it weapon grade stupidity. I want to say that we should be careful of what we do. Even me. And when I replied to this person saying that you do need to be careful, you need to be careful about what you do, you need to be careful about everything. You have one life. Make sure you get to live it properly and don't waste it and don't lose it on stupid things just because you are not careful enough. And the response I got was, should people or should women prioritize being careful as their number one priority when going out on a date or going out to a club or going out anywhere? Should they prioritize being careful? And I said, yeah, prioritize being careful. Everyone should prioritize safety first. Being careful. Safety is everyone's responsibility. You've got to be careful, be safe, look after your own drinks, look after yourself. Or you don't. She said, this person said to me, well, you, as a man, you don't go out without worrying. You, when you go out at night, you don't worry about how you dress. Or do you worry about the drinks that you take? And I'm thinking, well, okay. Yeah, right. If I'm wearing, I don't really worry too much about how I dress. Because, I mean, hey, I'm a fat, ugly fuck up bugger that no one's probably going to take two looks at me. And yet there are, I mean, if I wear just like a belt, two belts, one around my waist, one around my chest, I'm going to probably be arrested for disturbing this peace or something. But let's just say, if there are people out there who are not like that. There are beautiful people out there, angels from heaven here on earth in human form. There are goddesses, there are enchantments who weave splendor in every step they take. There are magnificent people out there whose beauty is beyond compare. And yes, they are going to get attention. Now, most people, when they go out, when they go out to like bars and clubs or such, or single people, and they want to catch a date, they want to like pick up people for whatever reasons. If they want to do that, that's fine. That's up to them. They dress to impress. They dress because they want the attention. They go out, they want the attention, until they get the wrong sort of attention, and that's where it kind of falls down. When the wrong sort of attention grabs them and they get raped that night, they get their drug, they get drink poisons, or they get date rape drugs at the point into their drinks, and they wake up the next day saying, well, you went out to get yourself laid, you got yourself laid, right, it's good of you. And then they will start crying rape and say, well, yeah, they did get raped because they weren't careful. Be careful. You're right, we shouldn't be in that situation. We shouldn't be in a fact where humans out there are raping people left, right and centre. But it is out there. Be careful with yourself. Be careful when you go out. There are so many times that I've listened to the news, and the first thing I hear when I wake up in the morning was a woman was brutally raped and murdered and then left for dead on the side of a road. I mean, I used to hear that all the time so much that I stopped listening to the radio when I woke up in the morning. It's depressing as heck. But like I said, that's the world we live in. And telling women that it's not their responsibility, it's not their fault, it's the fault of the rapist, they shouldn't be raping. Well, yeah, right, it's not their fault. It is the fault of the rapist. They shouldn't be raping. That's correct. But you can still do something about it. You have the control over your own destiny. You got to take things into your own hand and try, and with a little bit of common sense, not bring unwanted attention onto you. And if you did get that unwanted attention, have people around you that can help you get out of that attention. Have friends with you. Try to be safe. And I want to go back to the drink part. The person I was talking to on Facebook, they said, do you police your own drinks? And I was saying, yeah, damn right I do. I police my own drinks. No one takes a drink out of my sight. It is my drink. It can my beer. I mean, I will get my own drink from the bar. I will not let anyone else bring my drink for me. I mean, even if for some reason someone else did get a drink for me, I will probably like sneak around, but sneak it out and then get rid of it. I mean, I don't want to wake up in a ditch with my like kidneys missing because someone drugged my drink and then robbed me for everything that I have. No, I police my own drink. Yes, so should you. Everyone should. Women, men, all of us, we should be careful. We should police our own stuff. And that's not rape culture. Back to rape culture. The rape culture, as I now call, as I said, rape culture in what I put in quotation marks. Well, I should have kind of done this at the beginning though, but rape culture is saying that what we're living in now with people around every corner that could possibly rape you, and they want to try and move out of that. I can respect that, but it's not the rape culture. Rape culture, when you think of it, or when it originated, actually, I don't know about that. Ignore that. I don't know where it originated. But for me, in my mind, my idea of rape culture is based on, like, gang members, certain levels of society, where you bring in, when a new member comes into to the gang, and if they do bad, as punishment, you would rape their wife or missus. Or if a new woman comes into the area, they get hit on by every person in their group, every person in their gang, to initiate them. Rape becomes a part of their lifestyle. They get raped as form of punishment, initiation, or reward, because they said, okay, you got you went out and tagged so many buildings, right, so you can get Mrs. Bingledean for the night or something. And women are passed around as prizes or objects and such. That I considered rape culture. Not back when I was talking about the time of, like, Genghis Khan, when they would pillage an entire village and they would drag a woman out in front of her children, rape them, and then cut her husband's head off. That is barbarism. Rape culture is basically treating women as objects. That's not what we have here now. Nowadays, we are somewhat respectful of women. I say that dubiously, because I know that that respect can go up a heck of a lot more than it is at the moment, and that should go up, because there are certain women that need more respect than what they do have at the moment. But it's not the rape culture. What we have are horny people that don't have the level of mental equipment that we require to keep their own faculties in check. We have people who have knocked out their inhibitions. You can say they are in control or they're not in control. They're going to jail whatever which way. And for whatever reason or another, they want something and they go for it, because they got the power, they got the strength, they got the body mass. They can overpower the women, and that's why the males are the more dominant and will get objectified as being the raper and the woman the rapey. Well, yeah, however you want to throw that out. The man has more power. I know, forget your sexism and such. Not all men and women are equal. No, they're not. Yes, women can rape men. Men do get raped, but in the majority of the time, you will find that two people of equal levels, I'm not sure how we're even going to put this forward though, men are stronger in body mass in general than women. There are more things that a man can do to a woman that a woman can't do to a man. So therefore, a male will be more dominant than the female. And as such, in the rape area that we got, the rape culture as you guys are putting it, the man will force themselves onto the woman because he can. Because his mind's not there. He's intoxicated, he's horny as buggery, he wants something, he's probably been single for all his life, he hasn't had a girlfriend since his last missus split up with him 2-3 years ago, he needs some action, he goes to the local pub where all the females are gathering, gets intoxicated and thinks, right, I gotta have sex with someone now, and then tries to pull someone over. Yeah, they hit it off. They seem to, like, get nice and well, enjoying each other's company, go off to his own places. The guy thinks, yeah, I'm going to get some action tonight. The woman's thinking, oh, he seems all right. Yeah, I might like him. But then when it starts getting physical and starts dropping off, the woman has second thoughts. And then the guy thought, nah, we're going all the way late. We're going all the way. Be careful. There are people out there that will take advantage of the situation because they can. Be careful. I can't say anything more than that. And considering I've been talking for 20 minutes, which I was actually surprised about, yeah. Rape culture. Are we living in a rape culture? No. Is rape a problem? Yes, it is. Who should stop the rape? Both. The people who are doing the rape shouldn't be doing it. But the women or the people being raped should have some preventative measures. They should look out for themselves. I use the terminology in that Facebook post, and that was, don't go into the lion's den covered in meat expecting they won't eat you because they're all tamed. They're animals, and so are men. Well, mammals, but you get the point. Just be safe out there. Be careful. Look after yourself. Take preventative measures. And if things go the way you want them to go, good on you. Go make the night work for you. Not for anyone else. Make it work for you.